I'll guide you towards those we need to alert. Follow my directions, and we'll be done in no time. To the left, Connor! Keep going!
Hey-ya!
Redcoats. What are they doing here?
I believe we are on course.
They must
Excellent.
Be scouts.
We are right on course.
Be careful, Connor. We mustn't let them warn the others.
Turn right. Excellent. We are right on course.
We should dismount for this. It'll be quicker and quieter.
This is it! You have got the right place! Let everyone know that the regulars marched for Lexington and Concord!
The British are coming!
Back in the saddle, my friend! We have more people to warn! Yes! This is it! This is the way! This way, Connor! Excellent! We are right on course!
Wouldn't surprise me if we ran into more trouble. Stay alert.
This way, Connor! To the right, Connor! To the right!
Go left up here.
Excellent! We are right on course! Turn right!
Did you hear that? Could be redcoats. Careful.
None of this!
Let us continue the search on foot.
Whoa.
This is it! You have got the right place!
Spread the word. The regulars are coming out.
At once!
Excellent! We are right on course!
Connor?
Thank you.
Yes, this is exactly... Left! Turn right! Go right, Connor! Might be safer if we approach the houses on foot. This is it! You have got the right place! The regulars are coming.
Here! We're here! Get them!
Faster! We need to get away from them! Find a way to get rid of them, Connor! Well, I suppose that's one way to deal with the situation. Much too close for comfort. Let us take care to avoid any further surprises. Is everything all right, my friend? To the left, Connor! We need to lose them. Faster! We need to get away from them! Yes! This is it! This is the way! That was much too close for comfort. Let us take care to avoid any further surprises. Yes! This is it! This is the way! Go left up here. Let us continue the search on foot. This is it! You have got the right place! Where the devil is he?
Are you sure we are in the right place?
Well, sure, I'm sure. Prescott?
Evening, gents!
Listen, the regulars are out. You need to rally your men. And, put on some trousers.
At once!
Welcome to Lexington, Connor. Now let's find Hancock and Adams. No sign of Dawes. I hope he's all right.
Paul, Connor. Good to see you.
You need to leave. The Redcoats are coming.
Aye, so Williams told us. Let them conduct their little search. They'll find nothing.
You don't understand. Pitcairn intends to kill you.
I'm afraid it's true.
I suppose we have no choice then but to go. What of you three?
Dawes and I will continue on to Concord. Connor, it's best you stay here and help our man John Parker hold the town. It'll give us time to spread the word.
Your ground, men! Don't fire! Unless fired upon! But if they mean to have a war, let it begin here!
Pitcairn!
Disperse, you damn rebels! Lay down your arms and disperse!
What the deuce are you doing? Hold your positions! Cravens! Traitors!
They are not coming back. You will have to make do with those who remain.
Don't you lecture me, Orna. Return fire! Return fire! You need to get to Concord and warn the others. Show this to whoever leads there. Should be a man by the name of James Barrett. Go on now!
Run! Redcoats are taking captives!
blood's been spilled in Lexington, and there's more to come. The regulars are on the march.
You don't say. And why do you think I'm met up here? Go home, before you get yourself killed. I've enough to worry about without some green boy looking to play at hero.
I can vouch for him.
John Parker as well. Where's Revere?
Captured.
What?
Fear not. That man's no stranger to sticky situations. He'll be fine. I'm sure of it.
Your lady's finished gossiping? Parker seems to believe you're not completely useless, so I suppose there's a thing or two you might be able to help with. When the fighting starts, we'll need to hold those positions there. They're critical to the defense of Concord. Good boys. Not used to soldiering, they need some with the experience to direct them. That's something you can do. You'd best be telling the truth.
You have my word.
Then I suppose all that's left to do is wait.
Sir! Man the barricades!
No! Ensure my men hold those positions. If the Red Devils break through, we're finished.
What would you have me do?
Listen carefully. The Redcoats will form firing lines. Order the men to shoot just before the line is ready. Too soon and they'll miss their targets. Too late, and the enemy will open fire first.
Understood.
And if any of those bastards make it through, engage them. You must keep my men alive.
Wait for my signal.
Fire now!
Wait for the signal! Prepare yourselves! Open fire! Make ready! Go! Wait for my
fire!
Prepare yourselves. Prepare yourselves.
Shoot!
Wait for my signal. Make ready! Make ready! Open fire! Hold fire! Fire! Wait for my signal!
Fire now!
Wait for my signal.
Shoot!
Prepare yourself.
Fire now!
Make ready! Wait for the signal.
Fire now!
Wait for my signal. Wait for the signal. Hold fire. Wait for my signal.
Go!
Wait for the signal. Wait for the signal.
Go!
Fall back! Fall back!
We did it! The turning tail!
It takes a true monster to do something like this. At least they're gone.
I should have struck when I had the chance. Do you know where Pitcairn could have gone?
Back into the withered bosom of the British, no doubt. So that he may regroup and plan his next atrocity.
I need to find him. Every day I wait, more will suffer.
Chin up, friend. Many who should have died today now live because of you.
And what of them?
We do the best we can with what we've got.
It is not enough.
It never is.
For the support of the glorious cause. I beg they will accept my most cordial thanks for this distinguished testimony of their approbation. But lest some unlucky event should happen, unfavorable to my reputation, I beg it may be remembered by every gentleman in the room that I, this day, declare with utmost sincerity, I do not think myself equal to the command I am honored with.
Truly, as there is no man better suited to the task.
To assure the really? Congress that as I can no think of several. Consideration could have
Charles Lee.
Have accepted this arduous employment at the
do I know you?
I would not expect you to remember.
Come, Connor, that's someone I want you to meet.
I will keep an exact account of my expenses.
Sorry to pull you away
those
like that,
I doubt
but
not they will
the last thing we need is the two of you coming to blows. Connor, allow me to introduce you to our newly appointed Commander-in-Chief, George Washington.
Ah, so you're the one who saved Sam and John at Lexington.
It was the Patriots who did that. I merely lent support.
As humble as he is brave, we could use more men like you. I'm sorry, but if you'll excuse me, I should attend to Charles over there. He looks none too happy about being passed over for command. It was good to meet you, Connor.
Tell me you have news of Pitcairn.
I'm told he's taken shelter in Boston, where he's guarded by 1,000 redcoats. The only way you're gonna get at him is if we draw him out. And lucky for you, we're launching an offensive against the city in order to do just that. Israel Putnam has been given command of our forces. Present this to him, and he'll provide whatever aid you require. You'll find him at the encampment on Bunker Hill.
You have my thanks.
No need. It's the least I could do. Pitcairn's a dangerous man. The sooner we're rid of him, the better.
I would say the same of Charles Lee.
Now that's an altogether different beast. Let us leave it for another day. Best you head to Boston, Connor.
Men of greater resolve and clarity have stepped forth to make lucidity chief in our time.
Still here, are you?
I was just wondering, what happens now?
There's quite a lot to do. Commander Washington must determine when and where we'll strike next. And we need to get to work on our message.
Message?
We must contact the broadsheets at once. Ensure it's clear to everyone that it was the Loyalists who fired first in Lexington.
But no one knows who fired first.
Which is exactly why we must spread the news quickly. We'll determine public opinion.
This seems dishonest.
Perhaps, but so what? People must believe we acted in self-defense, else we've committed treason.
But you have.
Better to bow and scrape before a tyrant, then? Is that what you suggest?
No, of course not. No one should be denied freedom. And yet, to change the truth, it seems a dangerous road to travel.
Understand, Connor. This is a war fought not just on the battlefield, but within hearts and minds as well. There's nothing wrong with a bit of theater, especially if it saves lives.
Pence's traps, a guard dog, even a rather belligerent cat. I've consulted all the experts.
Hold and state your...
I'm looking for Israel Putnam.
On whose orders?
Samuel Adams.
Follow me.
This is not Bunker Hill.
Aye, it's Briggs. There's been some disagreement as to where we should encamp.
Any news from Boston?
The Tories aren't moving. And any time we try to press them, we lose a dozen men. I think Putnam and the others plan to assemble artillery on these hills. A good shelling might make the Redcoats rethink their strategy.
And what of John Pitcairn?
That bastard's the cagiest of the bunch. He's appeared time to time to taunt us or send regards by way of cannon fire. It's all right, though. He'll have what's coming to him soon enough. Just shot by Ed. You can't miss.
How much for your excuses, gentlemen? We should be building on Bunker Hill.
Breeds is closer to the city, but it is also closer to their artillery!
Ah!
I'm going back to Bunker Hill! Good day, gentlemen!
General Putnam.
What?
I'm looking for John. I was told you'd be able to help me find him.
He's tucked away inside their city with no reason to leave. As long as that ship continues its assault, we'll never flush him out.
But if the ship was silenced...
Oh, then poor John might be forced to get off his arse and come forward.
I should fly this flag to signal my success.
And I shall speak fondly of you at your funeral.
Thank you.
They've better numbers, you see. Better weapons, better training. But I do not fear. And neither should you. For what they have in material, they lack in conviction and care. But not us. We have discipline. We have order. And most importantly, we have passion. We believe. So maintain vigilance. Serve your ammo. Ensure a proper line of sight. And above all else, men, do not fire until you see the white of their eyes. Well, I'll be damned. You did it.
That was quite a speech.
Lies, all of it, I'm afraid. Still, such words have carried us thus far.
And what of Pitcairn?
He's left Boston. As I said, he would. And set up camp on Molten Hill. There's no good way to get at him. Not with that maelstrom brewing down below. I suppose you could circle around a bit. Or wait for us to thin their ranks.
There is no time. I will have to chance a direct approach.
That's twice today you propose the impossible.
I see no other choice.
Not because you're mad as a March hare, son.
I expect an apology on my return.
Why? Why did you do this?
To protect Adams and Hancock and those they serve. You meant to kill them.
Kill them? Are you mad? I wanted only to parley. There was so much to discuss, to explain. You've put an end to that now.
If you speak true, then I will carry your last words to them.
They must lay down their arms. They must stop this war.
Why them and not the Redcoats?
Do you not think we ask the same question of the British? These things take time. And it would have succeeded had you let me play my part.
Part of the puppeteer.
Who better we hold the strings than another?
No, the strings should be severed. All should be free.
And we should live forever on castles in the sky. You wield your blade like a man, but your mouth like a child. And more will die now because of that.
Sahan yanere me o tena am da setta kwe. Tini o me yaho tena tam da setta kwe.
How dare you sneak up on me like that? Why don't you just go out there and just help this camp retreat? Don't ever do that again, you hear me? God damn it!
General Putnam.
You live.
The same cannot be said for Pitcairn.
Well done, I suppose. But it matters little now. I'm ordering a full retreat. We have lost too many in exchange for too little. If the Tories want this hill so badly, let them have it. Boston is the true prize.
We have a bigger problem.
What do you mean? This can't be right. It says they plan to murder Washington.
My enemy is tenacious. When money failed them, they took to force. But I have slain Johnson and Pitcairn both, ending their plots. George Washington now rallies the colonists, and their march towards freedom begins in earnest. Little wonder, then, that the Templars now want him dead. They seek to reshape this land into something cold and ordered, something soulless. And he is an obstacle. I must save him, that his cause can flourish and my people remain safe. But the more I prod, the greater the chance I am discovered. The Templars believe their men lost the revolution. In their eyes, the assassins are gone and scattered, no longer a threat. But I fear they will soon discover the truth, and me along with it. I must tread carefully.
How fares the hunt, Connor?
There is progress, but I worry it is not enough.
You must strike where you need it most. What if you pursued Charles Lee and your father? What then of Paul Revere and the soldiers at Lexington?
Soldiers? There were no soldiers in those towns, only men and women who were forced to defend themselves.
Is this not why you fight? To protect your people? Your struggle is the colonists' struggle. In helping one, you help the other.
Encouraging words from one who thought mine a fool's errand.
Make no mistake, I still do. But I can't help but feel some pride in your success.
And why should I give you any credit?
Then don't. But first, Return the robe and the blade and the darts and all of the years of training and knowledge I have bestowed upon you. Return these, and then your words may have some merit.
Or you could just admit that you are wrong.
Oh, child, please, you've killed two men. One more salesman than soldier. You're gonna have to try a lot harder than that to impress me.
Is that so, old man? Or perhaps we should step outside. I will gladly demonstrate how easily I could trounce.
Connor, this is Benjamin Talmadge. His father was one of us, no need for secrecy. I think he has something he wants to say.
Achilles tells me you've uncovered a plot to murder the Commander-in-Chief.
Yes, but I have only false starts and dead ends to show for it.
Not anymore, my friend. Thomas Hickey's your man, and I aim to help you catch him.
How?
I'll explain on the way. You and I are going to New York.